Hello students of Standard 8, welcome to DAV Moyle Public School. I am your English teacher Jagruti Mishra. Let's begin our today's online session of English. Today we will continue with the same unit from your My English Reader Sports. And in this we will read today a poem, Nine Gold Medals. Dear students, when you participate in a sports competition, do you play only to win, to give your best performance, or to exhibit true sportsman spirit, whatever the result may be? You have to answer this by citing reasons for your choice. Do you know what is Special Olympics? Special Olympics is an international organization created to help people with intellectual disabilities develop self-confidence, social skills, and a sense of personal accomplishment. Among their other activities, Special Olympics conducts the Special Olympic World Games every 2 years, alternating between summer and winter games, especially for differently abled people. More than 2.5 million athletes of all ages are involved in Special Olympics. Sports training and the organization offers year-round training and competitions in 30 Olympic-type sports. Now let us read this touching poem about an incident in the Special Olympics. Nine gold medals. The athletes had come from all over the country to run for the gold or the silver and bronze. Many weeks and months of training all coming down to these games. Athletes from different countries have come to compete for winning gold, silver and bronze. They had done practices for months and weeks. The spectators gathered around the old field to cheer on all the young women and men. The final event of the day was approaching. Excitement grew high to begin. Spectators means the audience had gathered from all over the field for cheering the young women and men because the final day has approached and the excitement was even higher. The blocks were all lined up for those who would use them. The 100-yard dash was the race to be run. There was 9 resolute athletes in back of the starting line, poised for the sound of the gun. The blocks means behind the starting line of the race, the runners pushed their feet against each block at the beginning of the race. So they were all lined up and a 100-yard dash race was going to start. All the athletes were ready at the starting point and they were pausing, means they were ready for the sound of the gun. The signal was given and the pistol exploded, and so did the runners all charging ahead. But the smallest among them, he stumbled and staggered and fell to the asphalt instead. And as soon as the signal was given, the pistol was exploded and the runners started running. But what happened? Suddenly, a smallest athlete among them, he stumbled and he lost balance. He fell down and he fell to the road, preparing for a mixture of coal, tar and gravel. He gave out a cry in frustration and anguish. His dreams and his efforts all dashed in the dirt. But as sure as I am standing here telling this story, the same goes for what next occurred. This young athlete started crying in frustration. All his dreams were dashed in dirt. But I had witnessed what has happened. We cannot even think what has occurred next. Let's see what happened. The 8 other runners pulled up on their heels. The one who had trained for so long to compete. One by one, they all turned around and went back to help him and brought the young boy to his feet. To my surprise, what happened? All the 8 athletes pulled up to their heels, and one by one they turn around and help that young boy to stand on his feet. Then all the nine runners join hands and continue. The 100-yard dash now reduced to a walk, and a banner above that said Special Olympics could not have been more than on the mark. Then all the nine runners joined their hand, and that 100-yard dash running changed into a walk with carrying a banner in their hand, Special Olympics, which nobody can think. That's how the race ended with ring gold medals. They came to finish line holding hands still, and a standing ovation and nine beaming face said more than these words ever will by David Roth. So the race ended, and they all by holding hands came on the victory stand. All of them got the standing ovation, and all of them got the gold medals. Now read the extract from the poem again and answer the question that follows. Already many answers are done for you. Odds. The poet says the eight runners had trained for so long to compete. Why did they turn around and help the smallest boy instead of dashing for the finish line? What do you think? Just write your answer. Dear students, here are some more questions for you to solve. We will continue with this same unit in our next session. Till then, have a nice day. Thank you.